Shalom. It is I, the authorized representative of KAHANTAZADAQ, and yes, I am back. That ninja you'll love to hate. This message is for my good friend, J.D. Juan Doe, Mr. Mystery Man in Brooklyn. For Nicholas Kenneth Kerfoot. And of course, Mr. John H. that's recently popped up on the scene and went to use my channel to express his opinion. Okay, let's get after it. This is not legal advice, medical advice, or scientific advice. I only deal with facts. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, and I have not one iota of respect for you conspiracy theorists, because you confuse the world and you render the world to be confused as you merely are. Now, I want to talk about two topics here. Does your vote matter? And I want to talk about weather control, or as they say, cloud seeding. First, let's address, does your vote matter? First, I want to make it abundantly clear, just because KAHANTAZADAQ said Trump 2024 doesn't mean that he's voting. He's not voting. Most people don't comprehend KAHANTAZADAQ because he speaks in parables, as did Yahusha. In the 2008 presidential election, that can be used for a guide. The odds of your vote making a difference, let's say it takes, for instance, the state of California, is very slim to none. One in a billion, to be in fact. According to a study by Berkeley Law and Economics professor Aaron Edlin and his colleagues, your vote has about a one in a billion chance, one in 1 billion, of making a difference. Do you understand that? The research based their estimate or their estimations on multiplying the probability that your state will be decisive in the electoral times and the probability that the election will be tied in that state. See, as a state grows more populous, it becomes more important in the electoral vote, but less important and less likely to have a tied election. But the more people who vote, the smaller the chances that your vote will make a difference. Giggle, giggle. Quote that. The national average, according to the study, is around 1 in 60 million. Now, given the odds, the most economics agreed that the act of voting is simply irrational. And just because KAHANTAZADAQ is saying Trump 2024 doesn't mean he's voting. He understands this. Frustrated by the censures, KAHANTAZADAQ began investigating the cause and the benefit of voting to see if he could actually come up with a course that the chance of your vote actually making a difference and how things go down. But it's also the case that what's at stake goes up, because the more people will be affected by the election. If a person votes for the public good, and which what KAHANTAZADAQ was suggesting to you, do it for the public good. It's perfectly rational if you're simply doing it for the public good, for you to vote, no matter how big the election is. See, in a large election, you could actually have the potential to make a big impact for a lot of people. Let's take, for instance, United States presidential election that's coming up. It has a global effect by electing specific candidates or a candidate, a voter could actually help bring about policies that provide social services, foreign policies, tax breaks, and if you're a debtor, governmental benefits. Keep in mind how Trump's against the border, well, the Democrats has actually been for it. That would make a difference. The rational model doesn't hold for people who are actually not interested in the public good, as KAHANTAZADAQ is. If you're only doing it because you care about yourself and you want things to change for yourself, then you may as well keep your behind at home. Stay at home. The rational model suggests that in large elections, the chance of your vote counting and the potential that it would benefit you personally is worthless. You're going to be wasting your time going out to vote. The same holds true for landslide elections where the outcome is clear. Do you understand? So all this brings us back to, let's go back to the California election in 2008. Democrats, the Democratic presidential nominee in the state in which your vote only has about 1 in a billion. Your vote only has about 1 in a billion chance of being decisive. This is not, I don't want to disencourage you, because the odds that the vote will make a difference, it's just not there. Even if it's small, the stakes may be large enough to make voting worthwhile. You might be awfully happy just to hear mom say, hey, your vote made a difference. It doesn't. I'm KAHANTAZADAQ, and now you know my perspective. Stop thinking that you know me. You think you know, but you have no idea. Now let's move on. Let's move on to the next. And I got about 8 minutes to do this. I wanted to talk about cloud seeding. First, in the scriptures, to those of you that's a believer as I am, the book of Job 37:9, it says, out of the south cometh the whirlwind, and cold out of the north. So this is the Most High said he brings hurricanes from the south and the cold weather from the north. Find that to be true historically. Yirmiyahu 29:19, Jeremiah 23:19 says, behold, the storm of Adonai has gone out with fury, a whirlwind swirling down upon the heads of the wicked. Okay. Now, I could go on. I encourage you to also read Job 37, verse 1 to 13. Right. Now, I want to say this. There is no possibility using current knowledge and technology to use geoengineering, John Doe, John H., and Nicholas Carefoot to modify hurricanes. It can't be done. Hurricanes are from the Most High, that they refer to as natural weather systems. Now, typically, they begin in what is known as a tropical wave. It comes from a low pressure area, thunderstorm, and clouds develop. Now, strong wind pushes this system away from Africa towards America, conforming with the Bible says. So warm, moist air rises from the tropical Atlantic Ocean in the system of the clouds, and the winds begin to spin, which causes the hurricane. Not the government, not some cloud seeding. Climate change is caused by emissions of planet-warming gases like carbon dioxide from human activities. So it's not thought to be increasing the numbers of tropical storms worldwide. It's just not thought that. So by raising the temperatures, it do make the strongest hurricanes more likely. Warmer seasons mean that the storms can pick up more energy, potentially leading to higher wind speeds. Do you understand? Now, some users, well, you see them all over IG and TikTok, They're alleging that weather manipulation techniques like cloud seeding, right, JD, right, Kerfoot, right, John H., are to blame. What is cloud seeding, Tazadaq? Cloud seeding actually involves manipulating existing clouds to try to produce more rain or snow in countries with dry climates, for example, as far as the rain is concerned. But the southeast of the United States already had been hit with huge amounts of rainfall from the hurricane Helene, which triggered deadly flooding in several states just three weeks ago. So when cloud seeding, is it real? Of course it is. See, when they cloud seed, it's because they don't have enough water vapor within the atmosphere to see condensation occur. So what they do is they try and force it through cloud seeding. Now you can check this out for yourself. You could talk to these so-called experts in the weather phenomenon. In fact, there's one at Louisiana State University that I was reading about. Hurricane Milton is strengthening particularly quickly as it moved over the Gulf of Mexico, where the sea surface temperatures were around 1 to 2 Celsius warmer than it averagely is. So the peak sustained winds increase from 90 miles per hour to 175 miles per hour in just 12 hours on October the 7th, according to the national hurricane data. Now, for some of these social media fanatics like JD, John H., and Kerfoot, this sudden change was perceived as evidence to back their suggestions. This was not a natural storm. Oh no, this wasn't from the Most High. This is not Mother Nature. But instead, they say it's manufactured by humans. But this tends to fit with expectations of hurricanes generally intensifying more quickly in warming worlds. So as the planet, as we warm the planet, we anticipate a lot of potential impacts to the hurricane that could actually make them more damaging, including the ability to strengthen more quickly over natural warm ocean waters. This is what, I mean, now, mind you, there was a professor at Rouen University in New Jersey that stated this. Now, a new study released on Wednesday found that exceptionally high seas, surface temperatures over its tracks were made hundreds of times more likely by humans than warming, is what a lot of these people are stating. And so the problem with this, you get a lot of so-called professors that go along with this. And so because a professor said something that's more in line with your theory, you believe it to be true. But it could very well be an advocate just like you. Remember, there are humans that put their pants on each morning in their dresses or skirts if they're wearing those, right? See, cloud seeding is a type of weather modification that aims to change the amount or type of precipitation, migrated hail, or dispense fog, or what have you. So the usual objective is to increase rain or snow, either from its own sake or to prevent precipitation from occurring in days afterwards. So cloud seeding is undertaken by dispensing substances into the air that serve as cold condensation or ice So common agents could include like the silver, iodine, potassium, iodine, or dry ice. This dry ice material, like table salt, is it effective? Is it effective, JZ? Is it effective, John H? Is it effective, Carefoot? Whether cloud seeding is effective, statistically significant, it could cause an increase in precipitation is a matter of an academic debate that's been going on for a while. Studies has actually been questioned. There was a study conducted by the United States National Academy of Sciences, and it failed to find statistically significant support for cloud seeding effectiveness, Mr. JD. Now, based on his findings, Stanford University Ecologist Jerry Bradley stated, and I quote, "I think you could squeeze out a little more snow or rain in some places under some conditions, but that's quite different from a program claiming to reliably increase precipitation," end of quote. So there's data similar to that of NASA, right? It was acquired in a separate study conducted by Wyoming Weather Modification Pilot Project, whereas the NAS study concluded that it's difficult to show clearly that cloud seeding has a very large effect on the weather. That's what the study concluded. The seeding argument, the snowpack, by a minimum of maybe 3% over an entire season. So over an entire season, it only impacted snow for about 3%. Now, I know what you'll say. It's a lie. You don't believe it. But I turn your attention to this. What you're doing is you're creating a panic in people. Something that you can't fix, nor that can they fix, nor can you prove. But you go right on with the theory. If such is the case, and I surmise that you guys believe that they want to wipe out populations, why don't they just do it? Since they could do this within the twinkling of an eye, why don't they do it? Why haven't they done it? If they can control it, why not just stop all hurricanes? And if such is the case, and they wanted to wipe out an entire population in any particular region, why haven't they done it? This is to encourage people to think for yourself while you still can. Avoid these conspiracy theorists. Avoid people. Avoid these sovereign citizens that quote bits and pieces of law. Avoid these fanatics that seems as though they just want to keep you in panic mode. They're constantly talking about false flags when I've actually known some people that perish in some of these situations that they call false flags. Think for yourselves while you still can. I'm KAHANTAZADAQ. I don't teach you what to think. I teach you how to think so that you can think for yourself and avoid these fanatics that is just as bad as the de facto that they claim to want to move away from by manipulating your thinking. KAHANTAZADAQ, so you know who said it. If you found this video to be helpful, resourceful, leave a donation. Whatever amount you think the video's worth. If you didn't like the video, then piss off. Be sure to scan the barcode to purchase books, become a secure creditor, and other products. Like, share, subscribe. Thank you for watching.